Hello everyone, welcome to your favorite CAT prep channel Quantifiers. In today's question of the day, we are yet again discussing another question in algebra. So this is a question. To be very honest, the question is not that difficult, but what matters is the right kind of approach and the visualization that requires to solve this question in seconds. Let's see what happens. So ABC are the roots of the equation, this x cube minus px square plus qx minus r equal to 0. So this is the equation, right? We need to find the value of this a plus b, b plus c, and a plus c in the terms of pqr. Now the first thing that comes to everyone's mind and is correct, that what is the sum of roots for this? The sum of root of this is a plus b is equal to minus b upon a, which means that a plus b plus c is equal to p, because it's minus p of minus of minus p. So a plus b plus c is p. Now, if I replace a plus b as p minus c, so this becomes p minus c, p minus a, and p minus b. This is what it becomes, right? Now, from here, most of the people, what do they do? They try to open it, factorize, bring the common term together, and then do some cancellation. But what happens is, if you just realize something, what will happen? It will take only a few seconds. This is the equation, right? This is the equation. So if I have to write it in factor form, how will I write it? Can I say if a, b, c are roots, I will write it as x minus c, x minus a, x minus b? Do I generally also write k? But since k is equal to 1 over here, so I am not going to write k. Okay. So if I compare this with this, can I say like this is an equation in x, this is an equation in p? So I am just going to do one simple thing. What? That I am going to replace x with p, because my factor form is now in the form of p. So I just have to replace x by p. So my equation becomes p cube minus p into p square plus qp minus r. So p cube minus p cube is cancelled, and my answer overall is p cube minus r. This is my final answer. And within few seconds, I could have attempted it in an exam scenario. Okay. Instead of going into factorization, combining the terms and so on and so forth. So I hope that you guys understood it. And if you like this question, please do subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much, guys. Have a very great day.